Welcome to the week 6 matrix decompositions. In this section, we will study the LU decomposition and QR decomposition and singular value decomposition. Among these, this singular value decomposition is the most important in AI study. We need to understand how our computer understands and computes our data. Let's briefly introduce these three matrix decompositions that AI often use. Okay, we'll start from LU decomposition. Before we start, I will preview our lab in this web address. In week 6, matrix decompositions. Here, LU decomposition is a matrix decomposition that decomposes a given matrix A to LU, L times U. L is a lower triangular matrix and U is the upper triangular matrix. If we factorize a matrix as LU like this, then B is equal to AX. Solving this linear system of equation is like LUX like this. If we substitute this UX as Y, then this is solving the linear system of LY, which is much easier to solve in a very short time without much computing resources needed. It's very useful. And all this can be done by Gaussian elimination method. Okay. And this process also can be done easily in these steps. When we solve the AX is equal to B, then if we find the LU decomposition, when A is equal to LU, then we solve AX is equal to B by just solving LUX is equal to Y. Then from here, we find Y that satisfies LY is equal to B first, which is a very easy problem to solve because L is a lower triangular matrix. Then we substitute to this Y is equal to UX, which we did. We solve UX is equal to Y to find the solution X. Here, this is upper triangular matrix. So this linear system of equation is also very easy to solve by just substitute the XIs in that word. So if we could do this matrix decomposition by Gaussian elimination, then solving this problem is going to be very easy. And that algorithm, which is based on the Gaussian elimination, was coded as this command. Find the LU decomposition of A, A dot LU parentheses. This will give us PLU here. Then print this P matrix and L matrix and U matrix. Then this gives us for a given matrix like this, this command, this very simple command give us P matrix and lower triangular matrix like this and upper triangular matrix like this. If we have, so try to the other problem so that you can find from other textbook with this code. If we have a LU decomposition, solving this linear system of equation can be done very easily. Here, P is a permutation matrix, and you change the rows. Okay, here the command, find the LU decomposition of A, after you define the matrix A and the vector B, then all you have to do is solve the linear system of, which is LY is equal to B first, then solve. Next, solve UX is equal to Y to find the X. this will give us the solution minus 1, 2, 1 as a solution. Then also, which is the same as when you do the same command, A times solve right, B gives the same solutions here. Mm-hmm. And computing time, when matrix size is B, and this matrix decomposition shows the real power of these algorithms. And next one is a QR decomposition. And QR decomposition are using the Gram-Schmidt also normalization process here. Mm-hmm. When A matrix is given as a factorized as a QR, where Q is a unitary matrix, the orthogonal matrix. In complex orthogonal matrix is called unitary matrix. But anyway, we are studying a matrix in real only in this introductory course. So we have the real orthogonal matrix and lower triangular matrix R here. Then solving the linear least square problem, which is finding the best possible solution that minimizes the norm between AX and B. And this problem, if we can factorize matrix A as QR, then this problem is the same as this here. Least square solution could be found in this way when A is has a full column length. Then A matrix can be written as QR. So A transpose can be written as R transpose times Q transpose. Here, Q transpose Q is the identity matrix because it's an orthogonal matrix. So this can be simplified as this. Here, if R is an invertible matrix, then this can be canceled. So Rx is equal to Q transpose B gives us the solution X, which is a least square solution like this. This can be done with this coding, and this is a QR factorization code that I developed. If we practice it, then when we define a matrix A and finding the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, then normalize it to find the Q and R. Then if we multiply QR, then you will see this is the same matrix of what we had. So product of QR is the matrix A that we have. So find the least square solution can be done on AX is equal to B. Here, find the QR factorization first, and then you multiply transform this given linear system of equation AX is equal to B to here. We have a Q and R here, so we can find X like what we have here. This is the code that I made, which gives us a least square solution 0 to minus 1. But these two are important and interesting things. But the most interesting and important matrix decomposition is the singular value decomposition that we're going to learn today. Mm-hmm. And matrix A can be factorized as orthogonal matrix U times the generalized diagonal matrix sigma times the orthogonal matrix, the orthogonal matrix V transpose, like this. Here, this is called the singular value decomposition. Most important fact is this matrix decomposition can be done for any size of matrix, rectangular or square, and singular or non-singular, it doesn't matter. We can always find the singular value decomposition. So this is most important. We will learn the detail of the singular value decomposition. And code is also important, very easy. Then, the process is this, the finding the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and diagonalize it by Gram-Schmidt orthogonal normalization to find the orthogonal matrix U and V, then and the diagonal matrix sigma, then U sigma V transpose gives us the original matrix A like this. So when we do this singularity composition, all you have to do is find the singularity composition of A, A dot SVD parenthesis. This gives us U, sigma, and V. So this code just gives us U, S, which is the sigma diagonal matrix, and the orthogonal matrix V. If we multiply U, sigma, V transpose, then we will have the matrix A. As you see here, this is a very small number. It's almost 0 and 2, and this is a square root of 3 on both. So we see that this really works. Then we have the I have collected all the open problems in the last 6 weeks. We will study this today. Mm-hmm. Okay, here we're gonna start. Before we start, any questions? Okay. Now we are back to the main lecture of week 6. We had a preview on the lab. Okay, we start with the LU decomposition. LU decomposition can be found in here as a single web page that I made. LU decomposition can be done by this. Find the determinant, and the LU decomposition can be done here. With that, we can solve the linear system of equation. And this shows the steps. Backward substitution and forward substitution to solve this linear system of equation. And it can be checked, the two solutions are same with this. And this, I will explain it in detail in here. Two factors in LU decomposition is, one is the lower triangular matrix L and the upper triangular matrix U, where A is equal to LU, like this. When we have this matrix factorization by the Gaussian elimination, then the computation cost for solving a linear system of equation can be reduced dramatically. A can be written as a lower triangular matrix times upper triangular matrix, then solving this problem is same as solving these two simple linear system of equation with triangular matrices. So solving this linear system of equation is the same as solving B is equal to LY, and then solve UX is equal to Y to find X. Okay, here. Okay. So finding B is equal to AX is find the LU decomposition first, then solve find y that satisfies ly is equal to b, then find x that satisfies ux is equal to y. Then this x is going to be the solution that we are looking for. Okay, suppose A is this 3 by 3 matrix, then this simple command, find the LU decomposition of A as P, L, U. Here, P is a permutation matrix, and permutation matrix is introduced in here. So this just changes the rows of the matrix, and then lower triangular matrix L and upper triangular matrix X and U. Then this code gives us a permutation matrix. This means the second row and third row are switched. Then give us lower triangular matrix and upper triangular matrix like this. With this lower triangular matrix, we solve this Ly is equal to B to find Y, then substitute Y here to find X from UX is equal to Y. Here. Next, use those ideas, we can solve this linear system of equation. Find the LU decomposition of A here, then solve right this linear system of equation with the lower triangular matrix, then solve right this linear system of equation, ux is equal to y, to solve x. Then we have a solution x like this. This solution is same as the solution that we can have by the earlier code to find a solution, particular solution for AX is equal to B. Next, this LU decomposition was very important in old days. And QR decomposition was more important recently. And singular value decomposition at the end dominate the importance in matrix decomposition over LU and QR now. So in this introductory course, you only need to the singular value decomposition. But since you learned the least square solution, so this will be also interesting because this shows you how this QR factorization, QR decomposition can be used to find the least square solution. Okay, when a matrix A can be factorized as QR, where Q is a real orthogonal matrix and R is an upper triangular matrix. Then Q transpose Q is an identity matrix. So when we want to find the least square solution that minimize the difference between AX and B, if we can find the QR factorization, then this least square solution can be found very easily. Okay, we know this is a least square solution. Then, since A is equal to QR, substitute A as a QR in here, then A transpose is R transpose Q transpose, and A is QR, and A transpose is R transpose Q transpose. So here, Q transpose Q is an identity matrix, so it is cancelled, so we have only this. So if R transpose is invertible, then this can be cancelled, so Rx is equal to Q transpose B, and X can be found easily from here, the least square solution. So least square solution X hat is R inverse Q transpose B. It comes immediately. So now we can solve most of linear system of equation quickly with the help of computer coding. Find the QR factorization, QR decomposition of this matrix, of triangular matrix A. Then this QR decomposition based on the Gram-Schmidt orthonormalization process. So I made the code to do this QR decomposition. And the code, the Gram-Schmidt orthonormalization process was adapted on here to find the orthogonal matrix Q. And those codes gives us Q, the orthogonal matrix, and upper triangular matrix R. And when you multiply Q and R, then we have the matrix A here. So you can make changes on this code to do QR decomposition. If you have a QR decomposition, we can solve this problem for finding the least square solution. Okay, for this AX is equal to B, for the given matrix A, then we find the Gram-Schmidt orthonormal vectors, and then to form matrix Q, then R will be followed. So QR was made, then multiply as solve the R and Q transpose B. So X hat will be found as R inverse times Q transpose times B, which gives us a least square solution, 0 to minus 1. And you may practice on other problem of linear system of equation with this code, this algorithm that you just practiced. And you can find the more details in one simple web page that you can use. But as I mentioned, the most and important among all others this singular value decomposition is the most important concept among what we have learned in the last 6 weeks. The singular value decomposition always exists for any sort of rectangular or square matrix. Whether it is invertible or not, we can always find the singular value decomposition. This is the key feature of singular value decomposition. A singular value decomposition of an n by n matrix A is the matrix factorization in the form of A is equal to U sigma V transpose. U sigma V transpose, like this. And U is orthogonal matrix, and V is orthogonal matrix. And sigma is a kind of a triangle, generalized diagonal matrix, where this K main diagonal entries are positive, and all others are zero. This K meet with the rank of the matrix A. Okay. This sigma I's known positive eigenvalues in decreasing order is called the singular values of A. Okay, regardless of the size of the matrix, any matrix can be factorized in this form. Here, A is equal to U sigma V transpose. U satisfies A transpose is equal to U times sigma transpose times U transpose, and V satisfies A transpose A equal to V times sigma times V transpose, which means this A transpose is a symmetric matrix, so it's orthogonally diagonalizable, so we can easily find the matrix U, orthogonal matrix U, and also A transpose A is a symmetric matrix, so it is orthogonally diagonalizable, so we can easily find the orthogonal matrix V that satisfies this. So we can find U and V easily, and the sigma 1 is a K by K invertible diagonal matrix whose main diagonal components are positive. We call they are singular values, sigma i's. And these singular values are arranged in decreasing order. So in this decreasing order, some of these could be same, and all the other entries in this sigma is zero except those k singular values. We say these sigma i's are singular values of A. The singular values are generalized concept of eigenvalues. As you see, these sigma i's are non-zero eigenvalues of A transpose A or A transpose. As you see here. Okay. The diagonal component of sigma I are called the singular values of A, and the columns of U are called the left singular vectors of A. As you see, U is in left here, U is in left here, and V is called the right, the columns of the V is called the right singular vectors of A. As you see, V is on the right. U sigma V transpose, left here, left and right singular vectors. Those are the columns of U and V. Those are the singular vectors. As you see, A transpose A satisfies this, and A transpose A is equal to this. And sigma 1 is the square invertible diagonal matrix whose main diagonal entries are positive singular values of A. Okay, find the singular value of A. Here, for example, we have this 2 by 2 matrix. Then define a matrix. Then find the A times A transpose, A transpose times A. And find the eigenvalue of this A transpose A. Then find the singular values can be found and of this A transpose A. Then as you see, that the 9 and 1 are 2 singular value. The square root of these are singular values. This is eigenvalues of A transpose A. Mm-hmm. And as you see, we found the relationship. With those ideas, we can form a matrix and the orthogonal matrix V and orthogonal matrix U and diagonal matrix S. I just made a code to show how it works. So with this code, we were able to find the orthogonal matrix U, V and U and the generalized diagonal matrix sigma. If we multiply A U times sigma times V transpose, then we see it is the same as the given matrix A. This is a very important idea and most powerful idea. This code not only work for the square matrix or invertible matrix, but also work for the rectangular matrix and singular matrix with this code, this simple code. The above code can be summarized in this simple code. Find the singular value decomposition of A. Find A dot SVD parentheses gives us the U sigma V in this way. Make a print all three and then print the product of those, then gives us U is given like this and sigma is given like this. Those are the singular values and these are orthogonal matrix V. Then U sigma V transpose, as you check, it gives us the same matrix of A. This is 0, 2, and square root 3. So use this code instead of the above. Summarize all the earlier code to find the singular value of decomposition. When we do the computation on real, then RDF deals with the real matrices, and when we do need to compute the complex matrix whose entries are complex numbers, then instead of RDF, we can use CDF. Before we did use GG or for the rational number, we used QQ. For the real number, we used RDF. Real field, real complex field. Here, more details on matrix diagonalization can be found on chapter 8 in linear algebra. In this introductory course, I skipped the matrix diagonalization in short because this singular value decomposition covers this concept of matrix diagonalization, not only the matrix A, but also the A transpose A or AA transpose, in which is a symmetric matrix, which is orthogonally diagonalizable. So whether it is rectangular or square, or is singular or non-singular, this singular value decomposition always work. We can find the singular value decompositions, which is a kind of a matrix diagonalization that really works well in AI study. Okay, there are references on matrix diagonalization and LU decomposition and the QR decomposition. And I also gave a detailed tip on a singular value decomposition on here. Here, and also the theory of singular value decomposition was explained in more detail, the definitions and code and finding the singular values and finding the eigenvectors of A transpose A and finding the V transpose and finding the eigenvalues of A transpose and finding the orthogonal matrix U from the eigenvectors of A transpose, and we check U sigma V transpose is equal to A, like this. And those are the references that I used. And then last, I collected all the problems, open problems from the earlier lectures that include sketch the graph of the polynomial, sketch the graph of the complex functions, and draw a graph of a composite function, and find the approximate solution to f of x is equal to 0, then perform a matrix operations, and find the transpose and inverse matrix when it does exist, and similarity measure, and cosine similarity, and find the inner product and the angle of two given vectors, and find the RREF of AX, the other edge gate matrix, and find the least square solutions, and finding the singularity composition of a given matrix. I think that's it. That's for the first 6 week. Then we will continue in the 7th week on optimal solutions with our knowledge on calculus. Okay, we may review what we learned today once more. Yeah, we covered the three type of matrix decompositions. LU decomposition comes from Gaussian elimination, which make us to solve the linear system of equation easily, and the QR decomposition based on the Gram-Schmidt social normalization process, which gives us alternative way to find the least square solution of our given problems. And among these, the singularity decomposition is the most important that we all have to know in order to study AI. And for any size matrix without any restriction, A can be written as a U sigma V transpose, where U and V is orthogonal matrix and sigma is a generalized diagonal matrix like this. And we have a singular values of A here, which are the known the positive square root of A transpose. Then this K is same as the length of matrix A, and by using the eigenvalues and eigenvector and matrix diagonalization idea on A transpose or A transpose A, then we can find U and sigma and V without much difficulty, and all those can be done with a simple command: find A singularity composition. A dot SVD parenthesis gives us U, sigma, and V easily. Then we can check after we find U, sigma, V, then multiply U, sigma, V transpose, and we can check it gives us the original matrix. And this code not only work for the small size square matrix, but also large size rectangular matrix as well. Sometimes we may use a linear matrix here or complex matrix on here. I introduced the open problems, which will be a part of your midterm examination. Thanks for your attention. If you have any questions for the previous 6 weeks lectures, you are very welcome to ask questions in Q&A. Thank you for your attention.